Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss the instrument transformers and ratios of instrument transformers. So first of all, let us discuss what is the instrument transformers. An instrument transformer is nothing but the transformers used in conjunction with measuring instruments for measurement purpose are called instrument transformers. Okay, means instrument transformers are the devices or are the machines which are used in conjunction with the transformers in order to measure the voltage or current. Okay, the transformer used for measurement of current is called a current transformer or simply a CT, whereas the transformer used for voltage measurement are called the voltage transformers or potential transformers or simply PT. Okay, so we are having a CT and PT. CT is nothing but the current transformer and PT is nothing but the potential transformer. So before moving towards the ratios of instrument transformers, let us discuss the circuitry of current transformer and a potential transformer. Okay, so first let us discuss current transformer. Current transformer, okay, that is CT. Okay, so as a single instrument cannot measure very high current, so in that case we need to use the CT. Okay, a single measuring instrument is not able to measure a high current. A single ammeter cannot measure a high current, right? Where the high currents are present in real life? If you check at electrical substations, where having a current in the range of kilo ampere, whether that kilo ampere current will be measured by single instrument or the single instrument can measure that much of high current? Not possible. Okay, so therefore generally a CT is used. Basically CT is nothing but the transformer only, okay, which reduces the current level, which reduces the current level. Okay, so here this is nothing but a CT, that is a current transformer CT. Okay, and this is the simple measuring instrument, okay, which is of normal range. Okay, so if the current here is in kilo ampere, then this CT will convert that kilo ampere current into the ampere range. Okay, means that can be measured by a available measuring instrument or the ammeter. Okay, so CT. Similarly, we are having a potential transformer PT. Okay, PT, that is the potential transformer. Okay, so just like a CT, CT is used to reduce the strength of the current signal. Okay, similarly PT is used to reduce the strength of the voltage signal. Okay, means the high voltage which is of range kilovolt, okay, that cannot be measured by a single voltmeter. Okay, so we need to reduce the level of the voltage, and that can be done by using the PT, that is a potential transformer. This is the load. If you check at electrical substations, we are having the voltages of range kilovolt. Okay, so whether the kilovolt range can be measured by a single instrument or the single voltmeter? No. Okay, this is the primary voltage and this is the secondary voltage. Okay, if you check, it is like a step down transformer only. Okay, but it is a specially designed for reducing the strength of the input voltage, and generally it is used at the electrical substations. Okay, so friends, this is the basics of CT and PT. Next, let us discuss the ratios of instrument transformers. Okay, ratios of instrument transformers. Ratios. Okay, so we are having basically three ratios. In that, first one is transformation ratio. Transformation ratio. Okay. So transformation ratio, it is denoted with R, capital R. It is the ratio of primary winding phasor to the secondary winding phasor. Okay, or the primary winding variable to the secondary winding variable. Means in the case of CT, it is a primary winding current. Primary winding current WDG is nothing but the winding. Okay, to the secondary winding current. Secondary winding current. This is in terms of CT. Right, for CT. Similarly, we are having R is equal to primary winding voltage divided by secondary winding voltage. It is primary winding voltage divided by secondary winding voltage. Secondary winding voltage. This is for PT. Okay. So, this is the transformation ratio. Next, second ratio we are having is nominal ratio. Nominal ratio. It is denoted with letter KN. And this is nothing but ratio of rated primary winding current or voltage to the rated secondary winding current or voltage. Okay. Means here in the R, that is the transformation ratio, we are having the actual voltage and actual current ratio. Okay, so here we are having rated primary winding voltage, rated primary winding current, rated primary winding current divided by rated secondary winding current, rated secondary winding current, ratio of rated primary winding current to the rated secondary winding current. This is in terms of CT. Okay, and nominal ratio KN is equal to rated primary winding voltage, rated primary winding voltage divided by rated secondary winding voltage, divided by rated secondary winding voltage. This is in terms of PT. Okay, so this is about the nominal ratio. And third ratio we are having is turns ratio. Turns ratio. Okay, it is denoted with letter small n. Okay, so in a CT, it is a ratio of secondary winding turns divided by primary winding turns. Secondary winding turns divided by primary winding turns. Primary winding turns. Okay, this is in case of CT. Whereas in terms of PT, it is a ratio of primary winding turns. Primary winding turns to the secondary winding turns. To the secondary winding turns. Okay, this is in terms of PT. Are you getting the point? Okay, ratio of secondary winding turns to the primary. This is in terms of CT. Whereas in terms of PT, it is the ratio of primary winding turns to the secondary winding turns. Okay. So these are the three ratios we are having associated with instrument transformer. Okay. So similarly, we are having the ratio error and the phase angle error also, as well as the ratio correction factor also. Okay. That we are going to discuss later on. Okay. Thank you.